And teammate, if you get it, relative. For Cloud9, they are Twitter and send hashtag C9Win or hashtag T8Win to at LOL Esports, and we'll be tallying those up throughout the game already into week 3. Are the summer splits going? This year itself has gone by so fast, and we've already had an amazing amount of action, and it's only going to continue all the way up till another week 9. Right now, we're going to get on.
Going straight into Trinity Force Fizz.
That's a good point.
That's fun.
Oh. 15 Sands, Emperor's Divide does not get the range on Incarnation. It would have put him right in the turret range, and that is an error from Slushy and a first blood for Incarnation.
Yeah, that Emperor's Divide's a tricky skill right there. Slushy.
And it's going to be hard.
This game. It's going to be hard.
Walking around a security system of wards right now. Meteos was just able to put in, along with clearing that pink ward that Slushy put up. This could be the kill. Oh, right into the turret. That's what he wanted. The flash out from Incarnation. It's going to be Meteos to help him pick up the kill. That kill coming only from the bot lane because Balls was kind of left out to dry there. Not much anybody could do about that. Teammate knew that. Right onto Slushy, looking for the big one as well. Right back into the turret. Didn't actually get as much distance as they wanted, and it may save his life.
Oh!
He's got just about 10 HP. And the absolute zero zones out the fight just enough, but he stays in range for the piercing arrow. One more coming from Incarnation before he hits the ground. And now they're on the Lemonation. He puts himself back in the fight, so hopefully Sneaky can get away. But somehow, Teammate has found the fight. They call me wrong. Cloud9 did go too far, and they overstayed their welcome to get aced on this fight. It's only going to take a bit more. The big one hits, and he's going to get chomped down by the wolves.
Far too far on the chase to get a Slushy kill.
Slushy's going to go behind the turret. He completely whiffed that Chain of Corruption, firing it where Slushy actually would have landed, but he stopped on the structure, so that was very big as well for that to happen in favor of Teammate. Dragon goes over now, not gonna be stopped by Porpoise on that one. Nothing coming in the super rocket area. Oh, Nien very low, there's the rocket. Meteos gets to chum the waters. He's perfectly fine with that, he loves seafood. He's thinking they had a quick engage. Looks like it was called off there, maybe just safety for warding. And no, it is going to be a bit of an engage up onto Balls here. The team starts to collapse. They don't have Cali Trolls, but the teleport is up, and he will throw that down already. He's going to be right in the midst of the fight on this. Stops the TP. He's going to start walking up. They may not feel like they could win this fight right off the bat.
Yeah, Cali Trolls is now so far away. It's full retreat mode for Teammate.
Oh, Twisted Advance out in the end. Is the Valkyrie still there? He is actually stuck. There's the lockdown from Lemonation on the tether as well. The double kill for Sneaky. Things are just going wrong now for Teammate as C9 starts to put the heat on.
Teammate trying to exploit the wave clear of Cloud9. It almost looked like they caught Balls out of position, but the speed shields from Karma really reigning supreme. There's a nice knockback.
Hardly any damage to Meteos. Slushy was trying to get some pokes in, but he just gets shredded down himself. That's a triple kill overall for Sneaky. Those Lucidity Boots to continuously throw out the piercing arrows. 20 seconds on to Dragon before we get a little bit of that fight. Oh!
Got him.
Chain of Corruption does hit. Nien got the cast for Valkyrie off. It only gave him a little bit of distance, but he still goes down. That's two members for Teammate now lying on the ground. Incarnation trying to kite out of this one, but he gets trampled down by Dodo eventually, and they are going to be able to close in on this. We see that Sneaky got a kill on the top side there. They don't even want Dodo. Great focus, great call to go for the turrets.
And I love the confidence from Incarnation there to instantly flash all onto them right there, because that will grant them the second inhibitor, maybe full control of the game. And that's not a play Incarnation would have thought to make earlier on in the season, because he didn't want to be the one to mess up.
Nope.
This time, he's the one to make the play, and it grants Cloud9 a good edge.
They all follow through on that one. The communication
Porpoise better hurry.
At least on point for the time being. We do know the late game to be where Cloud9 can make some mistakes. Here looks like they're going to actually pick up one more advantage. The Twisted Advance. He's not going to be close enough. Oh, he steals the dragon. Porpoise gets out, though. I don't know if anybody's going to be able to chase, but Meteos. A tree versus a big man. Oh, here comes Incarnation from the other side. He's just going to pick himself up a freebie. Here's a gimme. Get some down.
Bullseye.
Bullseye.
Feel like.
And it looks really good with them 5-8. Oh, ball. Nope. Meteos, look out. Balls does go in onto Porpoise. It's very kind of tempered fight here. No, Dodo, however, in from the backside. Really heats things up. Lemonation goes down immediately. No more shields from him. Slushy gets taken out, so he cannot help control the zone now. Cali Troll still has a good amount of damage, but Sneaky has the peel. He has the kite. He has the quadra kill. 17-9.
Because Incarnation got wiped out right at the start of that fight.
Been a few times where they can take or lose him and then keep going in the fight. Chain of Frost, hit Callies. There's the zap as well, so they have full vision. Piercing arrow just off on the side. Shurima's Legacy is going to give a little bit of room to teammate, but not Slushy. He is invaded completely by that zap. Right onto Cali Trolls. Arcane Smash takes him down as well. And Cloud9 is not stopping. Anything that's in front of them is getting taken down right
now. Yeah, only one Nexus turret remaining.
Yeah.
Azir Wave Clear is gone. Yen trying desperately to spam rockets. I don't think it's going to be enough.
Not long for this world is that Nexus of teammates. 19-9 as Cloud9 come out with a pretty confident win here. It looks strong throughout. Meteos holding down his own jungle after being hit in the early game, and everybody came up for the victory. 21-9, 31 minutes in. Cloud9 take down teammate.
Cloud9 now an 8, and teammate now at 9.
Yes.
After this one. So not everything goes.
Solo mid taking on Team Dragon Knights. TDK win to at LOL Esports. As always, we will update those as we go through the game. And this is a Bishu get some kills game right here. Everything basically sets him up for kills besides Vladimir and Corki. This is going to be one volatile game.
I love this TDK champ select. They do persistently invade this blue buff.
It's like, would you like to help Latman or get your blue buff? How about no? Oh, he's going to cook him down. Evil Plague's on. It's the last bit of damage. They both flash it. Wow, Seraph gets a 1v1 on Dyrus.
And that's the only lane that had been winning for TDK.
Ass fingers right there.
Because a lot of times Malphite's flash first. So
see if he did.
Yeah,
he
flashed into
vision?
The brush.
No,
let
no.
Let me see. No, he walked in.
Whoa!
Jeez. The amount of time he had to react to that is
hot.
Split
damn.
Seconds.
All right, we got a fight in the mid lane, though. Bjergsen gets hit up immediately. Chrono Break back. He gets about 20% of his HP back. Not doing too bad for himself. And they are going to lock things down now. Bishu gets crushed down. Santorum picks up one there for himself. And they finally get back onto Bishu. Or dive and then Dragon Time. It looks like somebody's going to die in this one. Uh-oh.
Yeah. Five-man dive to only two people.
Dyrus TP already, so Dragon has to come with this, whether they get the kills or not. And it doesn't look like Smoothie's going to make it out alive. Latman tries the flash and Valkyrie to one side. Turrets on to Santorum. No trouble there. And Team Solo mid, like I said, it's going to be methodical as they start to press their lead. Get a five-man dive on the bot lane.
TDK needing... probably needing to make a bit of a move, but honestly, this early game's been very slow. Very, very slow. It seems like TSM is playing very safe against this unconventional team composition from TDK, but that puts them at risk, honestly. TSM made a 40-minute mistake in a team fight against Team Vigatoss. Would not want to make one here. Oh. Look at that!
I like what Bjergsen did there, but he actually put himself closer to Kez on accident. He gets the hit over onto Bishu. Bjergsen gets out alive! With the skin of his teeth on that.
Wow. Really impressive play right there by Bjergsen.
He will not have all the farm in the world to himself anymore. Oh, parallel convergence over on a Smoothie. He may be a Malphite, but he is a support Malphite. Timewinder on the way back does the majority of damage. Now Santorin gets the majority of Bishu's ult with the Kag on the other side. And Bjergsen getting out full HP. They're kind of just looking right now at a Smoothie with low HP. He gets out. A very nice equalizer actually on the team coming through. TSM still wants this. It seems like it was a bit hesitated though. Seraph making a transfuse kill here. Chrono break by Bjergsen, but he puts himself in a bad spot while being able to get a kill. And it's Seraph now starting to pick up kills. Dyrus a few more for himself. Kez can't figure out if he does want to. And TSM definitely has the Ward War 1 at this point. There's another flash. Dyrus also with the fast fingers this game. That's a huge ultimate. For one member they tried to use there, knowing the equalizer would actually win the dragon fight. It now is the thing pushing them away from the dragon fight. They're on to Seraph. He gets a good Hemoplague down, but there's no follow-up damage, so they're not going to be able to do much. Wild Turtle flashes over the wall to start this one off. That's going to be the parallel conversion shield also on to Bjergsen as he goes for Bishu. He'll get out alive, and TDK real good at disengaging right now, and they need to be.
Usually just end up in immediate death. Pretty good poke that's come out from Bjergsen's Echo. Well, there he goes, though.
The Echo ultimate actually right on the team. He's not going to be able to use it anymore for damage. There's a kill going on to Wild Turtle immediately. He even used the Summoner Heal there for the team. That is Bishu going down. Lampman on the outside, ready to hit some damage. Lustboy is on the top, charging. He can't really come back in yet. They're missing a lot of DPS here, and Lampman still able to fire out with Seraph in the middle of the fight. They push Team Solo Mid off of this one after TSM, for the last 3 minutes, was prepping this in the mid lane, poking one after the other.
But he has to do better than that. He's got to have a Santorin. Uh-oh.
There's that killer instinct, chat, right onto Latman, but do they go too far? Kez gets locked up as well. Whoa, Bjergsen goes so far in! The next phase dive flash, actually, to get the kill. Is it worth, however? Kez now on the chase. It's Lustboy and Wild Turtle. They split a bit, but the team is deciding that they can turn around and fight this one.
Maybe they're at risk if that brush got blind, ulted.
Ooh, Kez face checks. Oh, the outer layer of fat almost keeps him alive, but they crisp it up. Wild Turtle comes up with that kill along with Dyrus helping him out. He gets the full hit from Bishu on that last breath. One last hit, and he's gonna sweeping blade right through to safety as well. TSM loses two more to Kez now, just going down.
Health. Some pretty big items getting built up though.
Bjergsen getting his Lich Bane done.
Oh, he's in a bad spot!
Oh, he's in a very bad spot! You can't echo out of that if you don't hit the ground.
See, TSM's out of sync completely right there. What a game this is turning out to be. Completely unexpected to have such a close game 33 minutes in here. Seraph would have to teleport in afterwards. Missed initiation.
It hit. The channel got off. Latman actually took
Bjergsen's
the initial
in.
Damage from that. Bjergsen goes hard. Lichbane's able to crush down onto Latman there. This is the out. Now they don't engage on the fight. They take the advantage. They keep rolling with it. Double kill going over onto Seraph. Very nicely done as he teleported in for the fight. And it is going to be big now for TSM. That was the mistake they needed TDK to make.
Looked like Lustboy actually got the stun when he went in there,
right,
even though it was flashed away afterwards. So they were temporarily disabled for the Rek'Sai to come in, and that led to a big play from Bjergsen, who's now trying to make an even bigger one.
Oh, dog, you're not that powerful. Zhonya's goes off. Can they get over the wall? Here comes the equalizer. They lay out the red carpet for Kez, and Bishu's going to be in the fight as well. The Zhonya's goes down. So does Bishu. That's the ace as Lightman comes back up just now.
Clever play there by Bjergsen. He's Zhonya's. And then as he's coming out of the Zhonya's, his clone is right next to him, so he actually gets the full damage from his ultimate. Ace plus Baron, TSM back in control.
Back in control. I'll breathe a sigh of relief here.
I'd say 4-6 health right now.
Yeah.
And there's a fight. Ooh,
the
turtle
flash in. Bishu actually gets that as well. He gets right into the middle. Goes back in on to Wild Turtle, crushes him down. We're now watching Seraph take down Wild Turtle as well. These guys are just making it happen. Bishu looks for Bjergsen. He gets him. Santorin now is doing what he can as they claw through. And even though TDK was on the outside of the fight looking in, that Lich Bane damage doing some nice hits. TDK could try to go for broke here. Lustboy just putting himself right up front, says, here you go, here's Tibbers. Bjergsen picks down, or takes down Smoothie, and TDK is gonna have to fight this one in the Nexus turret. They let the inhibitor go down smartly, but they do not want to have that happen. It flies right in. Bjergsen instantly hits the Zhonya, is gonna be able to chrono break back, and he kills Latman with the chrono break. Right on to Seraph now. Bjergsen could go down. Seraph actually can't get any more transfusions out to hit him. Actually, he gets him with the Hemoplague as well. We talked about that earlier. And Seraph finally hits the deck. They're going to start hitting the Nexus turrets on the side of Team Solo Mid. TDK's base now in shambles. It took quite a while, 47 minutes for TSM to finally get to the Nexus. But they are able to pick up a win, now going 4-2. 47 minutes in, Team Solo Mid takes down TDK.
You said it there in the wrap-up, Riv, but it took them quite a while.
Pulse versus Team Liquid after starting the split
out of it. And for this one, you can vote again for the team who you think will come out on top. Tweet at LOL Esports with the hashtag TIPWin or hashtag TLWin, and we'll tally those up throughout the game. You saw the comps on your screen. You get one last chance to vote, no changing, throughout the game. We'll find you.
If it's on Twitter, you probably just send in two hashtags and...
Yeah. Which is probably the timing of when they think the bottom side would be cleared, and that's when they would catch Dominate. If it's the way it works out, they are perfectly on time for catching at least one up here at the top turret, and now they're going to get it. You said it was probably going to be TL that wants to take down these turrets fast. Adrian has to flash out. So does Rush. Two flashes burned. Bit of an erroneous dive there coming in from Impulse. They had the people in place, but they did not have the positioning. Once they got there, Rend onto Express on the potions there. Oh, he flashes away from Rush. They still get the kill onto Adrian. He's in turret shot range. Takes one. Quas could pick up a kill here, but they're dispersing too quickly. Messy, messy engage.
Early game power from Lee Sin also wants to dive and force action right away. Getting the kill onto Apollo is absolutely huge. Rush doesn't necessarily need the kill. They also force the teleport out of Quas coming up.
Oh, boy.
And Quas overstepping hugely right there. Oh boy.
For his life. They were inside his mind on that one. They waited. They said, and man, does he ever make a difference in the early part of games. Again, going warrior enchant, so he still wants to do damage on that Lee Sin throughout the game. Piglet, rocket jump in. Gets an explosive shot onto Apollo. Looks like it's going to do a good bit of damage, and it's enough from the front end burst to follow up with the CC, give that kill over to Piglet, and they still focus the Triss lane to get him going.
Really good gank. I mean, that's the one advantage the Team Liquid can have after the dive in the top lane, is their AD carry is stronger than the enemy.
Oh.
Temporarily, just because of experience.
Oh! Says, oh yeah? I can hit level 6. Do you want to watch your mid laner die?
Dominates in that brush clean.
Oh boy. Right onto Apollo. Anger toss as well. Here comes Rush in. Could get the kick back. They instantly pop down Apollo, though. That's going to be Piglet going down. He tries to jump over the wall, but he cannot make it over the top line of the trees without taking too much damage. Good stun back on. Wait, here comes a teleport in from Quas. That cannot be stopped by Impact. Here's the outplay. He's trying to get around Impact right now. That's what he needs to do to win that. But if Xiaowei Xiao already had the roam down, it could equal this out for him. And it does. That's 3 kills now coming in for Impact. Impulse, this is working out fantastically. Definitely a scary situation for Impulse to have to be in. Oh, that could actually be the kill. All right, he's Zhonya's out. Say one more follow-up. It is going to be from Dominate. That's his call. The team follows through. Rush gets hit. He'll safeguard back, and the team will be out for now. 35 seconds of the death timers we're looking at here, so a little bit for Team Liquid to work with. Piglet wasn't even in this fight.
It's all on Phoenix right there.
There's another ult. Another Tibber is not going in the right spot. Adrian kind of almost looking like he's feeling forced to throw it on these ultimates, forced to make a play for the team and get himself in
position. Team Liquid is controlling the initiations in this match. They have better crowd control. They built defensive, so it's very hard for Impulse to start fights on them. But now with the turret down, Quas looking to start a fight.
That's a big pile. Onslaught of Shadows right through the team would be perfect, especially with the turret still being up. It has about a half health. They go back onto Apollo. He's dip, diving, dodging out of this one. They're able to take down Quas. 3 members already down here for Team Liquid as Impulse just kind of waltzes out.
Now that he's hit level 16, the cooldown on his dashes is almost non-existent, 1.33 seconds. Per dash.
Oh.
Maybe we see a fight here. They decided to go.
5v5 in the mid lane. Adrian and Xiaowei Xiao very low. Fate's Call pulls him back and throws Adrian out of the fight, but he still goes down to Ignite. Quas is able to pick that one up. Now onto Impact, and Liquid found the exact fight that they wanted off of the dredge line from XSPECIAL. Very back and forth. Phoenix gets in. They try to actually get to the outside of the fight. Phoenix goes down. Impact's Flame Splitter was still on, and the Zhonya's Rush was able to hit the Sonic Wave. Resonating Strike not in range. You know he wanted that. And it's going to be Xiaowei Xiao in the chase. Not enough mana bar to keep finishing on that one, though. Apollo in the eyes of the entire team of Team Liquid. Quas picks up a triple kill. The Penta in his eyes. Xiaowei Xiao very low on mana. Definitely can't get the Rift Walk there. Adrian is going to thwart the Penta kill, and they are going to be onto the inhibitor turrets 35 minutes into the game.
Yeah, he may have thwarted the Penta kill, but did you just lose the game right there?
Yep.
That's Quas coming in with another great flank play on Hecarim. Tristana to take down these turrets. Team Liquid may have just won the game.
Quas said it would be from the angles of how he approached the fights. If he could do it better than his top lane Impact here in the game of the week, then the Team Liquid would come up with the win, and they have done so. 35 minutes in, Team Liquid take down Team Impulse.
And that's one of the most controlled victories I've seen a team have against Team Impulse. It got a little bit chaotic early, but Team Liquid built the defensive items they needed to, and then they just kind of waited and bided their time until they hit the item breakpoints that they wanted to.
Featuring Team Dignitas and Gravity, and Dignitas are riding a snow who you think will come out ahead of this game. Tweet at LOL Esports, use either hashtag DIGWin or hashtag GVWin, and let us know who you think is going to be taking this one down. Dignitas have a chance to tie back for first place. And if Gravity wins, they get within one game.
The Callista any, not level 6, so the tower dive much less potent.
Yeah, I don't know if it's going to be strong at all. I mean, 5-5-5 is maybe
six.
Not that much damage. Kimmy can take a whole bunch of pain, and he's on the wrong side of the turret. That's first blood over to Altec, and now they go in, and Helios going to be the second to die. Over greedy dive by Dignitas.
So usually you respect
from level 1. I mean, Shifter missed 5 CS in the first 2 waves because of the turret push here. And then we still had Key and Rome out of the lane first. Tiamat's done, going towards maybe Ravenous Hydra. Dive at the top lane is going to go in towards Hanser, but they're getting Dragon for it. And not the best equalizer.
No, that was a very bad equalizer. Definitely a misclick. Probably was trying to flash that way and clicked his R on accident, I'm going to say. But regardless, definite misplay there.
That wasn't, though.
With a Tristana that they've been able to shift over towards mid lane.
Uh-oh, and speaking of shifting over towards mid lane, Helios going to get knocked in by the explosive cask, and then he's going to try to flash into a tunnel, tunnel away as best he can, and oh my gosh, Helios might just get out. Just kidding. Flash, and the body slam means Hanser gets the kill with the equalizer.
Run around and pop AD carries early on.
That's true.
So it was even a takeaway from Gamsu. Here it goes, Altec into the turret, though.
Altec does summoner healed. Merlin Omicron cuts it in half, but 300 health on Tristana. Not a very happy health this time. Flash the way to...
Count to 10, see if he can get...
15, I think, now.
Well, keep counting, then.
9, 10, 11.
All right, he flashed.
Oh, he's dead. So it's CoreJJ, though. Hanser takes him out. Both AD carries fall off the map. Solo laners take him out, one for one. Dignitas finally get back on the board a bit more. Nice stun to Bunny Fufu. Moves around Helios to land the knockup. Anchor toss out of the wall. Good explosive cast to buy a bit more time, but Gamsu is on the chase. Dignitas really wants this, but so does Keen. The duck comes through. Down goes Annie. Helios about to say goodbye, Os. Hanser gets another kill. Who flashed?
Everybody's flashing, Freak. Gamsu's already used it, so he can't get out with it.
Gamsu's in the front. Not doing a whole lot of damage, though. Shifter's kind of alone at this point. CoreJJ stuck in base. No fight possible for Dignitas. No one's going to survive Tristana damage, especially when she's this far ahead in items. So you're absolutely right. Level 13, kind of the biggest she's ever going to spike in this game, and she's got items to back it up. Now CoreJJ going to get body slam flashed. Explosive cask actually gets him away from the team, and now he's going to be safe under his turret as Gamsu shows up to buy a bit of time. Maybe a bit overzealous as Bunny Fufu will get killed for his hubris.
Or Dignitas can wait for a misplay from Gravity.
That's how long it took him to finish it.
All right, here goes the call, though. They got the dragon, and they're going to move down. This should be a kill, as Xantos are very far from collapsing.
They take the turret down first, and now Gamsu alone gets Helios to help him out, but it's still a 2v3. Buster Shot gets away from Helios, and Rampage for Hanser as he does knock down the top laner.
Move once a piece. All right, he's getting bored.
Right. Wants to move. It's in his name.
Well, look how they've been able to gain position on the mid lane here.
Really nice. That's going to go down fast. Oh, they can't quite stay. Kiwikid gets the stun. Can they kill off Altec? Bunny Fufu down a little bit of health, but not enough damage comes through. There's just no burst on this lineup.
The duo tanks have to collapse immediately after that Annie stun. It's so late now.
Oh, man. The bounce house into the back line. Down goes Annie. There's going to be more soon. Shifter falls. CoreJJ also going to drop out. And it's a 4-0. Last man alive is Gamsu. Altec does not die. Turret goes down. Ace for Gravity in 32 minutes. And they're going to push into the base.
All right. They should be able to get the inhibitor off that fairly easily as well. Gravity finally crack open Dignitas base. See if they go for the end.
I think they can. You got 20 seconds on most of the damage dealing members. In comes Bunny Fufu to tank it up. Keen is gonna die. Ruins his fantasy score. His first and only death of the game. The base did, but Dignitas could not. Pie in the sky. 3-1 for Gravity. Are gonna try to close down onto the Nexus, but hold on. Dignitas respawn in time, and the lack of Keen is actually enough for the base to not fall down. And Rek'Sai is on the flank. Gamsu has TP. He pops it. Can they catch any of Gravity on the way out? This is how Dignitas beat TSM. Just some kind of catch. But no one's in range to stun Gravity.
Maokai's headed around. Does have Righteous Glory ready. There it is.
It gets popped. The great barrel by move. The slow last 2 seconds. Equalizer just says no thank you. No ulti. He's got flash, but he's surrounded. I don't see how he gets away from this one.
Save it.
Oh, CoreJJ.
Oh, he didn't get the cannon. He was trying to get that cannon minion before he died.
Oh, wow. Helios waiting in the wings in case there's a counter gank. There is not, because Baron's happening on the other side of the map. Gravity happy to take what they can with everyone else on the wrong side of the map. That's going to be a clean take. And you got a minute 20 till Baron. That's going to be easy.
Yeah, Dragon number Dragon. Five, pretty close. But they've got Baron buff. They're shoving in for the win here. Dignitas Gravity straight down mid lane.
Well, Haunter has teleport, so 18 seconds till it's five people, four versus five, just to take the Nexus.
Sorry.
Running forward, Shifter summons a turb. That doesn't keep the Nexus alive. Shifter gets killed off by Altec, but it's a four versus four. Haunter going to respawn in 2 seconds from now. They get TP in afterwards. Dignitas still wanting to fight. Here's the TP in. It'll be a 5v4 with Baron buff in Gravity's favor. They don't want to do battle. They will knock down Helios on the backside. There's the hook on a Gamsu trying to escape through some minions. Fate's Call keeps KiwiKit alive, but here they go. Down goes Gamsu, 4-17, and Gravity will move on to a tie for second place with this win.
Oof, what a clean win from Gravity as well.
Logic Gaming versus Enemy Esports. Now share your votes as the champions load into the Rift. Tweet at LOL Esports with hashtag CLG win or hashtag NME win. And let us know who you think's going to take this one. It's going to be a very fun battle. Counter Logic Gaming with a win can tie for first place or fall into a tie for second. Well, they could have killed that ward. Psh, lack of discipline on Zion and Doublelift. Already defensive wards for Enemy Esports. They will see this invade come in, but...
Oh, Doublelift with the check.
Wow, bad face check. Doublelift nearly goes down. Otter can't get the kill, but gets stunned up by Bard. Otter trying to run, still gonna be first blood. Goes over to Bard, but still more damage for Enemy Esports. Can they knock these guys down? Belter running. Smithy, one hit from dead. Another double stun by Aphram, who keeps him alive. And Inox, flash Q, fires back and takes down Smithy. CLG still get the lead for that one, though.
Doublelift, next level, AD carry, Bates there. Well, he's starting to shove it here.
Yeah,
looks
okay.
Like he put a few extra auto attacks.
Ooh, Trashy just barely got seen. That trinket just spotted the entrance, but Doublelift does not have flash, and he does not get the spell shield out in time. He has nowhere to go. What? Trashy pops the E with spell shield still on, and Zion Spartan TPs in to chase down, but maybe this is a bit too much for him. Bard showing up as well. Aphramu, flash stun, somehow gets them both. The ignite on the flares means a kill for Doublelift, and Trashy is super screwed.
He's definitely cornered right now. Four members. He wants a piece of Doublelift, but nice spacing there from Doublelift, and he's able to keep just out of the grasp. He'll probably have to stop off and get that blue buff, but once you transfer blue buff, Nunu is definitely set up to invade. Zion's getting a huge chunk here out of Lair.
Yeah, good luck. Player's gonna be from this one. Level 6 to level 5. Ignite is on. No thank you. Trashy shows up to not get the flash on Burrow, but Inox is here to knock down Zion Spartan. The flashless Gnar has nowhere to go. Can't dodge much of it. Inox gets the kill. Enemy keeps firing back. He said, okay, respect the Rek'Sai. She's gonna be somewhere nearby.
And they didn't really play it any differently, so.
Yeah, sure. If you fight bot lane, it's kind of the best you can do.
See, here's going to be a fight, though.
Doublelift tries. TP in from Gnar, who does not have a rage bar. Immediate stun, and a lot of damage coming through. Zion Spartan is going to lose his life for the hubris, and Smithy's in the wrong spot as well. Flashes the wall. No follow-up available. CLG, do not get the dive.
In the split push game, because... Vayne.
Ooh. Oh, Belter looked for the LCS big play, but he's kind of alone doing that. Otter's right here. Flashes up, but the flash follow will get him the kill. Now Zion's in the mix. They've got to be careful. The slow lands, meaning Aphro's now in range. Ice Blast hits as well, and Otter. Ooh. Thankfully, minions tank the stun. Instead, they go for the mid lane. They're getting a lot of damage through with Doublelift and Poe Belter. The Janna Shield and the Xerath Wave, they're not enough. Just the force on it, and CLG gets the turret down, but they're at half health. Flares is here. He finds Poe Belter. Another kill picked up. Nice Bard ult. He stops the two frontliners. Enemy get one, but they lose the turret.
I mean, they have to use Bard ult and Sivir ult. The outer turret.
Yeah, that was the risk, is, you know, CLG was going to get a better turret here. The ulti used by Xerath makes it a 1-0, but round 2 could still happen.
Well, Janna's also been sent back by Enemy. to help protect. And Zion once again.
Speaking of being sent back, Zion Spartan sent back to the fountain. Otter on a killing spree, 3-1-2. He gets Vayne again. He's having a similar performance his first game.
Question answered. Will Vayne be able to take down this Gnar in the side lane split push? Yes, she will. Smithy can't do much by himself, except Ward.
But he's ultiless, he's got teleport, but do you want to fight without any mobility spells on this dragon? CLG muscled their way in, they get the first dragon of the game, and they don't take much damage for it. Flare's fighting Zion Spartan, but I don't know if he's going to win this one. 11-10, Zion's Mega Gnar, he lands a lot of damage, and Flare's is not going to be able to fight back. The lack of ulti means he loses the battle. Zion wins 1v1.
That was just a poor choice from Flare's.
Actually, those stats start to matter, so a really important neutral objective pickup here, worth its weight in gold. Nice flash, ulti by Biodrop to set this fight up. TP is coming in, but will it be enough? Because the ulti from Bard buying a lot of time. Trashy being focused, double lifts low. In comes the Pony, knocks down the AD carry. Smithy forced to run, Flares joining Afro on a magical journey, gets stunned for his troubles. And it's the one for one off the flash ulti. Now Belter to buy a lot of time for his team. No further engage going to happen. CLG spent some time warding top lane. Baron ended up not being a factor just yet. But the ult's going to hit Inox. Not a good thing. Body drop going to sacrifice himself to put the ulti to buy some time. He will die for it, but the carry stays alive.
Wow, nicely done.
And body drop, he just respawned. Really goes down for it again, but enemy wants to fight anyway. In they go, Flares take a lot of damage. Smithy in the front lines, Flares goes down to Poe Belter. The engage means nothing, and now they go right back in, but they trade back. Belter is down, killed off by Trashy. Here's the chase, Smithy stunned against the wall. Otter's on a rampage, 4v3 despite the Baron buff. Baron Siege, three people still have this buff, which means it's gonna be pretty successful overall. Otter getting pushed around, the wave clear of Xerath not enough. Turret gets dropped, CLG on the counterattack, and a big ulti. It's Trashy and body dropped. Oh, the stun lands. Not good for enemy esports. CLG pushing in farther.
And they've got the Baron. Oh man,
they even caught Flares. Down he goes. Over aggression from enemy esports, cleanly punished by CLG. Okay, they're gonna try with two. CLG still in the mid lane. They could roam down, but looks like they will not come down in time. Dragon will go to enemy esports. CLG starts Baron, but enemy knows about this. It's dying so fast though. Double lift and Poe Belter, plus Smithy crushing the health bar. Zion on the wrong side of the fight, but it will be Baron picked up first. Anything gonna happen for enemy? They cannot chase this journey. Trashy knocked back over the wall, but that's all Emperor's Divide does. They're gonna catch Xmithy with another condemn. They're almost gonna get the kill, but Tempered Fate is gonna be massive. Body Chop has to try to save the team, but he gets chunked out. Afro dies at the 2-for-1, but Zion Spartan crushes the backline.
What
one versus three now.
Flank from Zion to come and cut off the exit. Very, very well played there from CLG. Trade the higher priority objective and able to turn around the team fight. Zion's not done.
Nope, he's on the hunt. He's got a red buff from his previous kills.
Hide and go seek.
All right, Flares hide and go seek champion 2015, but it's a 2v3. Counterlogic Gaming has Baron buff and all the big carries up right now to push down the base. Flares is here. He doesn't want to fight. He does, but after the turret dies, that's too late. He's going to die for his hubris. Inhibitor will go down as well.
I feel like he's given up at that point. If we're going to do ride to your death, at least it's going to be two inhibitors down here. CLG going to...
Now the respawns came in. Inox is already back, so...
Ooh, Nunu and Bard actually not going to make their way up.
Oh, man! Whoa, that was amazing. He predicted it. Oh, Inox, man. Tight corridors really help you deal damage. CLG on spawn, going for Baron number three. Enemy are around. Flares has teleport, but there's not. Okay, there are a couple of good wards now for this one. Body drop trying to buy time. Where's the engage going to be? Zion Spartan is Mega Gnar already. Otter lands a stun. No stun from Bard, though, and the engage continues, but they will knock out body drop. Afro gets chunked a lot. Comes through from Xerath and out goes CLG, but it's a 5v4.
Xerath ultimate available, but there's low.
He jukes, I think, every single one of them, and CLG still maintain control and enough health to keep fighting.
Signal for them to go.
It's going to be difficult. Low health on CLG, but no Xerath at all for enemy esports. Baron already dead. And now is a 5v5 with a Baron buff. Enemy Esports running as fast as they can. Another Tempered Fate dodge, but they've still got to be a bit careful.
Smith
in the front line. Here's the engage. Here's the jive in from Flares, and they don't quite get Poe Belter. Trashy in. He looks for Smithy. A shutdown as Doublelift goes down. Trashy still on the chase. Wants to get another one. Zion Spartan buying time. Inox misses the flash Q. Zion low, and Flares on the chase. The magical journey keeping Afro alive for now. And the E is timed out. The double stun keeps Afro safe. It's a 5v4. Trashy cannot land the knockup. He gets stunned again. Afro lives to fight another day. But mid lane's getting pushed. Enemy Esports are a lot of soldiers up right now from Pobel.
Gonna wait it out. Minions working on the Nexus turret up on top, by the way. That line of super minions will take out the Nexus turret by themselves if enemy do not finish this fight soon.
And Meganar's about to end, though. Zion Spartan back to mini means it gets a little bit better. How good is your spice steal? He gets it. CLG keeps the dragon off the table. And a huge Tempered Fate. Body drop to buy a bit of time. In goes Flares, looks for the back line. And when he goes down, they trade for Pobelter. A 4v4 and CLG are on the hunt. Doublelift spell shields the stun, and they chase in for Otter. He's gonna get slowed by Xsmithy, but will there be follow-up? Yes, there is. Trashy goes down. It's a 3v4. CLG on the hunt. Otter gets the kill. Can he get the outplay? He looks for Doublelift, but he goes down. There's the slow to Inox. That's gonna be the game. Counterlogic Gaming in 48 minutes.
Woo! And the teleport up to the super minion Zion just to gain a little bit of distance, and they're going for the Nexus turrets.
There's no way this Janna stops this push. Doublelift has super minions in the base. An incredibly hard-fought game. The chance for CLG are in the audience. They earned it, and Counterlogic Gaming ends week 3 tied for first place.
What a fight from enemy.
Absolutely.